Hi friends, welcome back to my channel and welcome if you're new here. My name is Jen, I'm a certified weight loss and nutrition coach and I'm on the WW or the Weight Watchers Blue Plan. Happy Wednesday. It is Wednesday, it is what I eat in a day. I have such good food to share with you guys. One of my new favorite salads, I shared this on my Instagram. So many people DM me asking about this salad. I'll be sharing that in today's video. And we're going to be talking all about the changes or alleged changes coming to WW in the beginning of November. So if you're excited for another What I Eat in a Day, give this video a big, huge thumbs up. If you're new or you haven't yet subscribed, I would love to have you here. Hit the subscribe button and click the bell right next to it so you never miss a single video. Make sure you're checking out the description box down below for my two recipe ebooks. I have breakfast and I have lunch. Both contain 15 recipes with all WW plan points included as well as calories. I'm about to release the dinner ebook, so make sure you grab these two before the third one is released. You'll also find nutrition coaching. Highly recommend personalized macros and calories. That way you kind of know what to reach for every day to lose weight, maintain your weight, or to reach your health goals. And if you'd like to chat with me directly, I offer one-on-one coaching as well. Links, discounts to everything I share with you today, as well as all of my other favorite things, and of course my Facebook group, come on over, join us there, are also down in that description box. So we have lots of good food, lots of interesting topics to discuss, so let's jump in. Here's my breakfast this morning. I'm really excited for this. Of course, I'm having some blackberries. These are huge blackberries. And then I made a little egg scramble. It just sounded really good. So I had two full eggs, one egg white. Three of the sausages, they're 1 point a piece, so that is 3 points of sausage. And then I did, out of my little cracker cut pack, add two slices of the Jarlsberg Swiss, which is basically half of a slice of cheese, so that would be 2 points as well. So it is 5 points for my scramble, 0 points for my blackberries. I am working on cup number one of water, so it is 5 points total for this morning's breakfast. Good morning, guys. Welcome to this week's What I Eat in a Day. I'm working on my second cup of water. I wanted to hop on, show my face, say hello, and I thought that we could chat a little bit about all of the rumors and speculation of what is changing when it comes to the WW plans in November of this year for 2022. Before we jump into the conversation about the rumors, I did want to let you know that there is confirmation that Mindy Grossman, the CEO of WW, will be stepping down from her position, I believe, at the end of this year. So that speculation or rumor has absolutely been confirmed. Anytime WW changes their plans, which generally seems to be every couple of years, there's lots of rumors and speculation that floats all around. So what I'm going to be sharing with you today is from a blog called The Holy Mess. I will go ahead and link that down below for you, as well as other sources out there on the internet, boards, videos that share some of the information that has been rumored to be changing with 2022 and the new WW plans. So there is confirmation that the new plans will take effect on Monday, November 8th. There was information saying the 11th and the 8th. The 8th makes more sense because it's a Monday. The 11th is also a holiday and a Thursday. So it seems to be confirmed that these changes will be taking place on Monday, November 8th. So what are these changes? So again, there's been lots of different information floating all around. There is one portion of the new plans that is somewhat confirmed, and that is that they will be releasing a diabetic program, AKA low carb program. So it sounds like they're going to be putting out a supplemental program that is in addition to the plan or plans of the regular members of WW that is more tailored towards diabetics, which to me means that it's going to be more low carb. There's also lots of speculation and rumors that the plans are going to be more personalized. So your dashboard on your app will look different than my dashboard on my app. There was also some speculation that the three colored plans were going away and that there was going to be one plan. Now, that is speculation. I'm seeing information saying that that is going to happen, and I'm seeing information saying that the blue, green, and purple plan are staying, but the quiz that you take when you join WW, or for members, apparently current members are able to take this more extensive quiz as well. It's really going to give you a more personalized plan, kind of back to that personalized WW. It's going to be called WW Plus instead of My WW. And again, it's just supposedly going to be much more personalized. Now, I don't know exactly what this means. I don't know all of the changes that are going to be made, but to me, that means that the foods that I eat that are personalized to me may be more, less, or different in points value. And again, my app is going to look different than your app when it comes to foods. There's also lots of information that in these test groups and these test pilots of the new program, that point values of some things are changing. It sounded like some of the point values were actually going up and that we are going to be receiving more points per day. Now, I don't know if that means that they're taking away weeklies and just giving us extra points day to day, or if we are getting more points day to day plus weeklies because the point values of certain things are increasing. It sounds like in-person workshops are staying and that they are going to expand their coaching to little 5-minute or small minute segments of coaching if you have a question or just need a little bit of motivation. Now, as you know, I don't utilize any of the coaching because I'm a coach myself, but it sounds like that is going to be a feature that is either part of or in addition to your standard membership. Like I said, we're hearing that it's going to be called WW Plus, but we're also hearing WW Personal Plan. So over here on the Holy Mess blog, I want to read you this section. It says Instagram Pandemic Points also shares this information taken from a WW survey. And it says introducing WW's most cutting edge, comprehensive, and personalized weight loss program ever. Cutting edge because it takes the entire nutrition label into account: calories, protein, fiber, saturated fat, unsaturated, healthy fats. That's interesting. I wonder if that's going to mean that they're incorporating healthy fats more. That would be music to my ears. That is one of my biggest beasts with WW, how high in points healthy fats are. And it says, and added sugars are all included in the new points formula. No other system seamlessly reduces all this complexity into one simple number. Comprehensive because it just isn't a food system. It's an entire ecosystem that takes the whole you into account, incorporating your activity levels, your water, and vegetable intake, allowing you to grow your points budget and earn points for all the healthy things you do. It's one complete system that takes all into account. Now, I had heard some rumors about being able to earn extra points every day for drinking water and eating your vegetables. So that's interesting. I'm not sure how I feel 100% about it because I don't know all of the information, but that is quite interesting. Personalized because for the first time ever with WW's guidance, you determine your own individual plan based on the foods you like and eat most often. These foods have 0 points and your plan is unique to you. With thousands of possible combinations, no two plans are alike. So quite interesting, again, being able to personalize it to you. And I'm wondering if you are someone that eats a lot of, say, healthy fats like avocados or peanut butter, are those foods going to be 0 points, or how is that going to look? Because those are pretty calorically dense foods, and if they make them 0 points, there's a possibility that you may overeat them, taking you out of a deficit. I'm not really sure what all of that looks like, but I do like that WW's trying to make it more personalized. I will also say that I hope that they include calories and or macros as part of their changes, because as you know, so many people undereat on WW. It's one of the main reasons that I choose to count calories first, because you don't want to be in too severe of a calorie deficit. It also says that the new plan will be even more simplistic and easier to understand, with a special focus on the first 30 days that a person is a member. And it also sounds like WW is going to be offering courses or tutorials on how to use the app, because a lot of people struggle to use the app. Now, on the Holy Mess blog, and this was updated September 30th, and I think some things have changed since then, or speculation has changed. This says the current plan, green, blue, and purple, will be ending. But I did also hear recently that that's not the case. So that is one thing we're not 100% sure of. That's still under wraps. Are we still going to have the three plans? Are we going to one plan with that diabetic plan as another option? And this says the new plan includes a diabetic-friendly plan that's also helpful for insulin resistance. Perhaps this will include allowing for more healthy fats without high point penalties, and would be more helpful for people who need to eat lower carb. And then it says this is not expected to be very low carb like keto, which is great because keto isn't sustainable. And then it says the new plans are said to have more options for people who need a special diet, such as gluten-free WW members and WW vegetarians and vegans. So that's pretty much what we know right now. Like I said, there's lots of speculation and rumors. We don't really have anything 100% confirmed other than the release date of November 8th. That is supposedly 100% confirmed. There are a lot of people testing out the new program, and there are individuals who have sources that are testing out this new program that are sharing information, and that's where a lot of this is coming from. I think the biggest things are they taking away the three colored plans and moving to one plan plus the diabetic plan? And what exactly do they mean by it being more personalized to you? And lastly, I want to know, and I'm hoping that this is a change, that they limit the number of 0 point foods, especially if they're going to make high calorie foods 0 points. I feel like they should be limited to 1 to 2 servings, and then points should be added after that. That's just my take on making it a little bit more healthier, well-rounded program. And of course, you know, I want to see calories. So let me know down in the comments what you guys think about these rumors and speculations of the new plans. And of course, as soon as any concrete information is released, I do not want to release a video based on speculation. But once the new plans are released, I will absolutely be putting out a video immediately explaining the new plans and exactly what that means for us on WW. So let me know down in the comment what your thoughts are. I find it very interesting. I'm very intrigued. I'm ready for some changes when it comes to WW. I'm ready to see if I want to continue to stay on WW based on these changes. I have a lot riding on what's happening in November of this year for 2022. So let me know down below what your guys' thoughts are.
What are you guys doing? Lola, Palmer? Hi, baby! What you doing? Are you playing? Oh, yeah, you guys are out here playing. It's such a nice day. Come on, Diesel. Oh, I was going to show you guys. Remember that wrap I told you we bought when Diesel had his ACL surgery so he wouldn't lick the wound? Say, my mom put this on my front leg because I have a wound I keep licking. He has this sore that he keeps licking, and the only way to get it better is to make it so he doesn't lick it. So we went ahead and put that wrap thing on his leg, and so far so good. He's kept it on. We just have to watch this part here under his other leg to make sure it doesn't rub it raw, but we're doing good, huh, Diesel? Yeah, we're doing good, huh, buddy? Get him, Lola. Get him, Lola. Get him, Lola. Hey, Crazy. Hey, Palmer, the Cray Cray. Hey. Get him, Lola. Get him, Lola. Get him. Where you going, bud? Poor Diesel, still limping a little. Here, I'll put your guys' dog bed down. So you guys can lay outside if you want. Dog bed. Palmer. Palmer. Look what Mama sees on the table. Palmer. Troy put all his balls and his stick up here when he was mowing the lawn. Palmer. Palmer. Look. Palmer. You ready? Go get it. Good job, bud. Good job. Bring it back. Good job! Oh, attack mode is on.
I'm gonna have my morning snack. It is currently 9:45. If you didn't know, I filmed these videos on Sunday, which is the same day that I meal prep. So I've been meal prepping all morning and I'm now getting a little bit hungry. So I'm going to have, of course, my kombucha for the day. This is the Brew Doctor in Island Mango. I picked these up at Costco. If you haven't seen my massive grocery haul that I put out on Saturday, I hauled these in that video. And then tis the season, I'm going to have one of the Verb Pumpkin Spice Latte Bars. I love Verb Bars, you guys know that. They have 65 milligrams of naturally occurring caffeine, what is in green tea. So no weird toxins or chemical additive caffeine. It is actually from green tea. They have good ingredients. They're 90 calories a piece, 3 smart points. What I love about these is in this bar right here, there is, again, 65 milligrams of caffeine from green tea. So it gives you that little bit of energy that you need midday. I also use these pretty regularly as pre-workouts, or like I said, just midday afternoon slump where you need energy. It's just a great way without jitters to get that little bit of extra energy. The pumpkin spice latte is so good. It is pumpkin. It is spicy. It is latte. It is so, so good. Here is the size of the bar. Mmm. So good. Like, so incredibly pumpkiny and spicy. Again, 3 points on all plans, 90 calories. I will link Verb down below for you. You can get a sample bag, which is this right here. You pick the flavor for only $10. That's 12 bars for $10. And then Verb throws in 4 or 5 extra bars in other flavors for you for free. So you can try out some other flavors for when you want to reorder. But I love Verb. I get a bag pretty much every single month I go through it. I will, again, link it down below. With the link, you will get the $10 sample bag price, which is an incredible, incredible deal. It ends up being 55% off of the regular price. So 3 points for my amazing pumpkin spice latte bar from Verb. And then WW counts kombucha as 3 points. I count it as 1 point. It's 80 calories in the bottle. So this is my 4 smart point snack. I mentioned in my grocery haul that I have been craving salad, so I bought everything to make salad. I'll share a pro tip with you guys while I eat my lunch, but my salad, I use the Earth's Best Kid Chicken Nuggets. I used to love the Kid Fresh, but these actually have a lot better ingredients in them, and I really like the breading on these, and it's a big chunk of chicken. It's literally like the chunk of chicken wrapped in breading. versus more of a chicken nugget, if that makes sense. So 6 of these is 4 points, which is not bad at all. And then I have 2 points of avocado, making 6 points. I have 1 point of cheese for 7 points. I also added 2 points worth of crispy onions. I love crispy onions. When I saw these at Costco, I thought perfect for salads, perfect for wraps, perfect for everything. They just add that perfect flavor and crunch to your salad. So I have 2 points worth of those. And then I have 2 points worth of light ranch. This is completely gone. That's the only dressing we have on hand. I didn't plan very well because I didn't buy salad dressing, but that's enough for my meal. So my salad is a total of 11 points. This is all I'm going to have for lunch besides water. I'm still drinking lots and lots of water. I'm about halfway through my gallon. So this is today's lunch. Let me sit down and share with you guys some pro tips for salads. I will make sure that I put this recipe on my recipe website as well. Okay, so pro tip for salads while I mix this goodness together. I'm more likely to eat salad if I prep it. So over the weekend, I chopped up romaine lettuce. I also chopped up the bell peppers and the green onions that you saw on my salad. I'll make sure that I have most of the prep work done. So all I have to do is basically assemble like I did today. And that just makes me more likely to eat salad. If I have to chop everything up, I'm probably just going to pick something else for lunch, if I'm completely honest. And another thing is, when you're making a salad, make it fun. It doesn't have to be boring and bland. That's why I like adding those crispy onions, and I'm totally willing to take the points on those. I add avocado because that makes me use less dressing, makes it a little bit more creamy. Just add fun things to your salad for taste and texture, and then it's just not so blah and boring. It's actually a really satisfying, healthy lunch. It is a little bit higher in point, but again, just by adding those fun little touches to it, a lot of low calorie, high nutrient dense foods, you can really make it just taste a lot better and not just a boring, bland salad. I'm about to hop on my Zoom call with my challenge group, but I'm having a little snack. This is one of the Oikos 000 in strawberry. I added about a tablespoon and a half of the Purely Elizabeth granola. As you guys know, I do not count points for granola, so my yogurt is 3 points. I'm not super, super hungry. I've really been trying to get that gallon of water done, so it's filled up my belly a little bit, but I did want to have a quick little snack before my call because we will be having a little bit later dinner tonight. So Oikos 000 with Pure Elizabeth granola for an afternoon snack. For dinner tonight, I am making a 30-minute pizza pasta skillet. I'm so excited for this. Two of my favorite things, pizza and pasta. Let me show you what's in dinner. First, you're going to need light mozzarella cheese. The pasta that I'm using is Fiber Gourmet, as always. You guys know how much we love this pasta. Game changer. The taste, the texture, everything is so good about this pasta. I'm going with the elbows. It is only 100 calories for a 2 ounce serving versus 210 calories of traditional pasta. So it's half the calories. It's less than half the points. It's only 2 points on all plans for 2 ounces, which is a lot, which is a quarter of this bag of pasta. It also has 25 grams of fiber versus 2 grams, so quite a lot more fiber. In fact, your entire day's worth in pasta, which is incredible. 17 net carbs versus 41, and 7 grams of fiber. I buy mine off of Nutrition. They have the best price and the biggest selection. It comes in 4 shapes, linguine, which is a spaghetti noodle, elbow, rotini, and penne. Tonight, we're going to do elbows. Highly, highly recommend. Try this, you will not be sorry. We also need 1/2 pound of 96% extra lean ground beef, a green bell pepper, turkey pepperoni, sliced olives, and then the recipe calls for marinara sauce. I would recommend using a 0 point marinara. I don't have any, so I'm going to use this pizza sauce, which I also count as 0 point. So the first thing I'm going to do is start browning my ground beef. I'm also going to chop up my bell pepper and my pepperoni. I can watch you sinking down on the bottom ship. So come to sending again, Mississippi. Once the hamburger is browned, we're going to add in 2 ounces of chopped turkey pepperoni, and we're just going to let this cook for about another minute or so. Now we're going to add in our bag of Fiber Gourmet pasta, uncooked, 3/4 cup of water, and your 0 point marinara. Stir that all together, and we're going to allow it to come to a boil. Once it comes to a boil, I'm going to reduce the heat to medium-low, pop on a lid, and we're going to let this cook for about 10 to 15 minutes. We want to make sure the pasta gets cooked all the way through. The pasta is done, so now I'm going to add in half of a cup of black olives and stir those in. I have my cut up bell pepper strips, and I'm going to just place those right on top of the pasta. We're going to add 1 cup of the light mozzarella cheese right on top. Move it from the heat, pop the lid on, and allow it to sit for about 3 to 5 minutes or until the cheese is melted, and then dinner is ready. It is that quick and simple, under 30 minutes. I have to say, this looks absolutely delicious. Look at that. This entire pot makes 4 servings. I have some broccoli, hello, in the microwave warming up. I'm going to dish this up. I'll be back to share points and calories. So here's my dinner for tonight. This is a huge serving of the pasta. I don't even know if I'm going to be able to eat all of that. But again, that entire pot made 4 servings. It is 7 points on all plans, 383 calories. And then I do have some broccoli here. And I did add 1 point worth of Parmesan cheese to the top. So my dinner is 8 points total. Here is my dessert for tonight. I'm having one of my Heavenly Hunks, the birthday cake from Costco. These are absolutely delicious. I really like them. I have to say the oatmeal chocolate chip one is a little bit better. I'll buy that next time, but this is just a perfect dessert. I'll open it up and show you guys what they look like. So here is the size of them. So they're pretty good size. So that is my dessert and my final little snack or meal of the day. Thank you for joining me on another What I Eat in a Day on WW. I hope you enjoyed coming along with me today, seeing all of my meals, that delicious dinner recipe. You can always find all of my recipes on my website. I will go ahead and pop that in at the top of the description box down below. Let me know down in the comments what your thoughts are on the upcoming potential changes for WW, and I will go ahead and link that website down below where I gathered today's information. As always, I will be putting out a video as soon as the official information is released from WW. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and of course, if you're new or you haven't yet subscribed, hit that subscribe button and click the bell next to it so you never miss a single video. We do What I Eat in a Day every single Wednesday. My 2 recipe ebooks, nutrition coaching, links, discounts to all my favorite things, and of course my Facebook group are all down in the description box as well. Thank you again for watching. Happy Wednesday, friends, and I'll see you later. Bye!